Hello, I am fine art photographer Matt Seuss, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to use printer profiles inside of Adobe Photoshop 2024. I am on a Mac, and I am using OS 13, and this video is for OS 13 and newer, and I'm also going to be printing to an Epson printer. Now, I already have my file ready for print, so let's go ahead and click on File and click on Print, and the print dialog box is going to come up. First thing you're going to want to do is go ahead and choose the printer that you're going to be printing. I'm going to be printing to the Epson P700. And then next thing you want to do under color management, you want to change this, and you do not want the printer managing colors. You want Photoshop managing colors. So go ahead and change that. Once we've switched to Photoshop managing colors, we can ignore this little warning box that's up above here. Next thing I'm going to do is click on printer profile, and I want to choose the profile for the paper that I'm going to be printing on. To get these paper profiles, be sure to visit redriverpaper.com/profiles and install them before you're ready to print. Now for this example, I'm going to be printing to the Polar Gloss Metallic paper with my Epson, so I'll select that profile. If you are printing from a 16-bit file like I am, go ahead and click on this checkbox here to send the 16-bit data. I also have normal printing, the default, selected. And then we want to choose rendering intent. Now for photographs, you're going to really choose between relative colorimetric or perceptual. And most of the time, you're going to be printing with relative colorimetric. When editing your photo, it is quite possible that you are using colors that just can't be reproduced by your printer. Those are considered out-of-gamut colors. The rendering intent will help map those out-of-gamut colors into reproducible colors. Relative colorimetric will hold all original colors that the printer can print and shift the colors that are out of the gamut to reproducible colors. Perceptual, on the other hand, will shift all the colors to hold tonal separation. When using perceptual, you may find that some of your colors are a little less saturated than what you would expect, and that's why I generally prefer relative colorimetric. Now, if you do notice any banding in your colors using relative colorimetric, that's going to be a good sign you need to switch to perceptual. For this photo, I'm going to choose relative colorimetric. And then go ahead and make sure black point compensation is also checked. Down below here, the only other thing I make sure I have selected is under the position and size to make sure that it's going to the center of the paper. On the left over here, we can go ahead and get a virtual idea of how this is going to print out by clicking on Match Print Colors. And this is going to give us, again, a virtual representation of how our print will look, especially when we choose the Show Paper White option. We can also go ahead and view our gamut warning, too, to see which colors are going to be out of the range of the printer. Note that when choosing any of these boxes here, this is not going to affect print quality at all. It's just going to give you a virtual representation of how your print will look. Now let's go ahead and do our printer setup. The layout, we can switch from portrait to landscape. For this case, this is a portrait photo. I'll leave that in portrait. And let's go ahead and click on print settings. You want to make sure that you're printing to the correct printer. Choose your paper size. For this, I'm going to be printing to US letter. And then let's go ahead and take a look at printer options. On the color matching, if we click on this, everything is grayed out as expected. This is because over here we have our Photoshop is going to be managing colors. If Photoshop was not managing colors, you would be able to choose options inside of the color matching. Let's go ahead and go to printer settings. Now, under the media type, under the photo papers, these are installed by your specific printer drivers, and these cannot be changed, so you cannot add Red River paper papers inside here. But you do need to choose the right paper source, and if you look at the instructions PDF that came with your profile download, we have instructions on which paper to choose here based on the paper that you're going to be printing to. Now, for the metallic glossy paper I'm going to be printing on, it tells me to choose the premium photo paper glossy. So I'll go ahead and do that. Now under color and color mode, those are grayed out, and that is because we have Photoshop managing the colors and not the printer managing the colors, so this is all correct. So then we'll take a look at print quality. And instead of standard, we suggest going with either high quality or with max quality. And feel free to go ahead and experiment with the max quality carbon black or quality options, and you can specify if you want to have the gloss smoothing and if you want to turn off high speed. High speed, what that does when it's enabled, the printer head will print in both directions. It'll lay ink in both directions. If you turn off high speed, it will lay ink in only one direction, allowing for a little bit more drying time between passes on the ink head. For this particular photo, I'll just leave this on max quality. and then I'll go ahead and click on OK. Last thing you might want to check is under the advanced media control. You may have different options depending on your printer. And on this printer here, I can adjust the color density if I wanted to. And we have instructions on if there's any settings that you need to do in the instructions PDF that is downloaded with the profiles. So I'm not going to do anything with this. I'm just going to hit cancel and then I'm going to hit save. And the last thing to do is to just double check all of my settings are correct. And then I can go ahead and click on print. If you have any questions at all, you can reach us at support@redriverpaper.com. And again, to download the printer profiles, go ahead and visit redriverpaper.com/profiles.